Hi everyone, Google Cloud Next 25 Tokyo brought a lot of new announcements, but one of them really caught my eye, which is this one. This is supposed to be a new AI coding teammate on our GitHub repository, which is all connected to the Gemini CLI GitHub action. And the reason we actually got this new teammate is because the team of Gemini CLI needed something to help them with automated all the tasks and requests they got into the repository of Gemini CLI. So they just built their own tool and they decided to expose it to us. And this is what we got yesterday, actually. I wanted to do a dive in into this, and I decided while I was playing with this just to open the camera and show you what I did and what you need to do in order to play with it as well. The first thing that we need to look here is that this is the repository of this tool. It's called Google GitHub Action, and you don't need this repository. You only need the documentation, basically, because if you already installed Gemini CLI, then you're fine. Just make sure that you are updated to the latest version. That's important. And then you're running it, and basically you just need to run this command. This is the setup GitHub. It takes a few seconds, and it's all done. Basically, what it's doing is just adding this library to your .github directory. And this is all the action that GitHub need to know in order to run. The next thing you want to do, which is not specifically written in the beginning of over here, I don't know why, they just say you try it out, but when you try it, you will find it that you need the Gemini key. So how you edit it, you can look up in the documentation, or let me just save you some time. And if you're going to your repository, go to setting. Inside setting, go to security action, and you need to add a new secret. It should be the Gemini API key. That's the key of it. And you also need to add the key. If you don't know how to get the key, just open a new tab, go to ai.dev. That will bring you to AI Studio. Inside AI Studio, get API key, create new API key, and you will get like a string. Just copy it to the right place and you're done. So this is the only step you need to do in order to start working with this new action. Oh, there's another thing you probably need to do. You need to commit everything and push it back to GitHub, so you will have the action in your code. And once you have it in your code, you can start playing with it. So the first thing I did is I created a new issue. And this is a project that I'm building for myself and for my family. So I just get like a very, very narrow description that usually I won't use when I'm using AI tools. Usually I'm giving a more depth description what need to be done, but I just want to play with it. So I said, yeah, let's just write something. So I ask it, this is like a shopping list that have dual languages, so you can use two different languages on the same item. And I said, okay, if a user hit enter when he's editing an item, I want him to, well, first of all, update as it's supposed to update, but also start a new item. So you can go look to the next item and start entering a new item. Once again, this is a very poor description to give to an AI, but never mind. And once I finish with that, I run the triage option. So I just wrote this line, this, and you can find all of them in the documentation over here. It's all of them. I just took one after the example, one after the other. Sorry. I did this, and then it's run an action. And in the end of the action, he added a new label for it, which is a bug. So let's just go to the action and see what exactly he did. So this is the action he ran for the triage, and I'm going inside. And here you can see all the steps it ran. And if I will open, I think this one, we can actually see what he did. So it's run this, it runs some kind of a prompt, which allow him to see the issue and everything he needs to know about the issue. And then you can go through this blob of text, and he's just like trying to understand what the issue is about. And then he decided that the issue is a bug, and then he just decided to label it as a bug. And that's what he did. And that's what we can also see on the issue, that the issue is a bug. Now, how did he did all that? And that's, I think, the most important thing is if you will go back to the action that Gemini put inside the workflow, you can actually go and see the prompt that it ran. And you are an issue triggered assistant, and just go over it. It's very simple. And I think that's the beauty of all of it, because this is a nice template that worked for Google. But if you are working with GitHub and you have a different method how to run your issue, just go to the prompt and change it to the way you want it to do. And I believe once you will go and read a little bit how they did everything here, we can actually do more action. You can add summarization for it, or you can trigger other action or whatever. So this is the first thing that I did, and it looked fine. I could have done it myself and just wrote it as a bug, but never mind. But usually when you have other developers that going into your open source and just adding issues, sometimes you need to go over it and just have more classification. So that's the first thing that I run. And then I try the most important thing that I wanted to try, which is a Gemini CLI fix this issue. Now, remember, this is not a description that I will usually give to an AI, but never mind. I did it anyway. And then it took it like a few minutes to come with a plan, and then it executed a plan. So let's just go back to action to see exactly what happened behind, under the hood. So I think that was the action. No, that was the action. Sorry. It's a little bit confusing, all the name. And here we need to go to run Gemini. And now we can see exactly what happened. So we started, he read the issue, and then he read the code, created a plan, decided he can make the plan better, and updated to the plan. And then he started executing the plan and write on the code. And that was, for me, a weird situation, because up to now, my coding experience with AI started when it just was like, autocomplete, and then I move on giving it a short task, but I can see the task, and then I start using cursor, but I still see all the changes, and I can go change by change and decide what I want to apply and what not. And then I start working with Gemini CLI and Claude code, and now it's, yeah, they're just changing a lot of code, and I need to decide which one I want to look, but I don't go in line by line now, and I have trust with the issue. This felt a little bit weird because I don't even see the code. I don't see that he's doing anything. I just see if you go back here to the issue. So there is this plan with checkbox that he did. And then in the end, he couldn't do the pull request. I don't know why. So he told me to do it myself. But it was a weird experience. Just let it go and let's see what we got. And it worked. Did it work well? Let's see. So let me go back to my code here. Since this is a Flutter project, so if that was a web project, I would probably have GitHub pages already there, and I could just test it on the fly and see if the change worked well. But this is a Flutter project, which means it's a little bit more harder to all of the AI to work with, because they're doing Next.js better than they're doing Flutter and Dart, which makes sense. There's more information on the web about a JavaScript project than Dart and Flutter project, but it's still doing a great job from my point of view. It just takes it a little bit more time to find all the bugs and correct it. So yeah, I'm going to change. Oh, it's created a new branch for it. It named the branch itself. And once again, if you don't like this naming, I'm sure you can go to the prompt and just change it to whatever you need. And now when we have this, let's just run it and see what we're getting. Okay, so this is my app. This is the shopping list. And now I want to add a new item. So I'm going to edit one of them. Clicking enter. And yeah, I got a new line. It didn't focus here, so I probably need to change it. But it did edit. And will it translate it? Yeah, it did translate it. So that's working. Once again, the description wasn't that good, so I could do a better description about focusing it and adding new to stuff. But basically, we got a code that's working. And I would probably go to the pull request. Oh, there is no pull request. Sorry. I will go to the branch. And I will compare it just to see exactly what's going on behind the hood. So it did change the Gemini setting JSON, which is a little bit annoying because I like my setup, but it did override it. He created a plan, which I love. I really like this idea. I'm doing it myself. When I'm working on describing what needs to be done with AI, I always ask him, just create an MD file with the plan, with checkbox, and just keep marking the checkbox. It really helps when you overuse the model. Sometimes you're just getting to the threshold and it says, okay, I cannot continue, wait 3 hours, 5 hours, next day, whatever. I'm usually using another tools, just moving to a different tool. So if it was on cloud code, I will go to Gemini CLI and vice versa. But it was in the middle of the work. So when I have the check plan, I can just go to the next one and say, look, your colleague just finished this task, continue from where they stopped, and they will continue from the same area. So that's very nice that it did it itself. And then we can see all the changes and I can go over them and decide whether they are good or not good. Is there anything else? No, that's it. That's the entire thing. They asked me to create the pull request, so I can definitely create a pull request. And I won't be surprised if we can actually, let's try it out, because I think you have also automation on pull requests with review. So I'm not going to write anything about this pull request. Let's just create a pull request and see what happens. Okay, he added a new action, which is Gemini pull request review. That's what we wanted. So now we can see it, the action running live. And I'm not sure what he's testing on the pull request review. We should probably could read the prompt here. Let's see. Still running. Okay, let me pause the video and I'll come back once it finishes and see what. Okay, we are done. It took it 3 minutes to code review the code, and let's go back to the pull request. And you can see that now it's green. And okay, so we did the summarization, review summarization, and he have some remarks about the code. And yeah, and I can probably code here and called Gemini CLI to fix it if I want to. But in the meantime, while it was running, I went over the prompt. I highly recommend it to read other people's prompts. Usually I'm going on open source on GitHub and just going to the prompt directory and just reading and getting new ideas. It's a nice prompt that easily can be changed to the way you would like to have your pull request review. But yeah, very interesting. He did a pull request. He marked it as green. So this is probably, this is low and this is medium. So no big problem here. And I'm ready to go. So will I use it? Yes, definitely. It won't change the workflow I'm doing right now. For instance, I like to do code review with a different tool that wrote the code. So if Gemini wrote the code, it will be Claude that will do the code review and vice versa. Probably I will have to find a way to do it in here. So if I'm inside an issue and Gemini is writing the issue, I will probably go to a cursor, open Claude code and tell him just go and do a review for this specific change. But other than that, it looks amazing. It's very easy that you can put it on action. And it's nice template, because if you are a heavy user of GitHub, then you probably already have the flows that you like to create. And now you have an automation tools that using AI just to make it faster and seamlessly. You just need to create an action and it will run when you're doing something or let something happen, or just do it on the nightly. Yeah, we have all the option now. It's a great start to build something awesome. And I'm sure that if you have new ideas, just go to their repository and add more issues. They have a tool that can build it. So it just help other people in our community to learn from your achievements. That's it for today. If you learned something new, please subscribe and share this video with others. Thank you very much. See you.